the reflection and refraction of light influence our everyday life. Here you can see a laser beam that passes through a plexiglass object. The way these optical waves change direction when they pass into another propagation medium is equal to that of seismic waves. The reflection and refraction of seismic waves allows us to explore the Earth's subsurface. Hello and welcome. In this video, I show you how the reflection and refraction of seismic waves allows us to illuminate the Earth's subsurface. Fundamentally, the law of reflection and Snell's law of refraction determine this. I derive both of these with the help of Huygens Principle. A consequence of this is the seismic head wave, which plays a significant role in refraction seismics. Why are seismic waves reflected and refracted? One answer is the Huygens Principle, which was published by Christian Huygens in 1678. This allows the derivation of both phenomena using graphical means. According to the Huygens Principle, every point on a wavefront is a starting point for a spherical wave. This is a new wave, which spreads in a radially symmetrical manner at the propagation velocity of the medium. The overlay or superposition of all spherical waves is what forms the new wavefront. This is a line through the same oscillation phase of the waves. Imagine a straight wavefront produced on top of an infinite number of waves. In order to make this clearer to see in the animation, only a few selected starting points are illustrated. On the wavefront, these spherical waves arise simultaneously and propagate at constant velocities in a homogeneous medium. The superposition of the waves now forms the new, straight wavefront. This works in the same way for a curved wavefront. Using this principle, reflection can also be explained. The straight wave impacts on a layer boundary, at which the propagation velocity of the seismic waves change. According to Huygens, this creates a new wave at every point of contact, which then propagates with a medium velocity. Since the contact points in the example move from left to right, the first produced waves propagate further than the later ones. As a result, the newly emerging wavefront is inclined with respect to the layer boundary and mirrored with respect to the original incident wave, with the same angle alpha to the perpendicular. This describes what the law of reflection is. Angle of incidence equals angle of reflection. At a layer boundary, the waves are not only reflected, but they are also refracted. If a straight wavefront meets a boundary surface of a medium with a different propagation velocity, some of the seismic energy is refracted into the lower medium. The behavior can again be described using Huygens' principle. At every point of contact of the wavefront with the boundary layer, a spherical wave is initially produced. In this example, the lower medium has a lower propagation velocity than the upper medium. V2 is less than V1. The newly formed waves now propagate more slowly, and thus they produce smaller circles than they would do in the same time in the original medium. If you connect the circular waves, a new wavefront results. The angle is dependent on the medium velocity, and it results in Snell's law of refraction. Sine alpha 1 divided by V1 equals sine alpha 2 divided by V2. At a boundary to a slower medium, refraction occurs towards the perpendicular, at a faster medium, conversely, away from it. The seismic velocities in the Earth typically increase with depth. The ray paths towards the Earth's interior are as such refracted away from the perpendicular. The rays that return to the Earth's surface are refracted towards the perpendicular. This is the reason why ray paths are typically curved within the Earth. If the wavefront impacts the boundary so that alpha 2 is equal to 90 degrees, the refracted path runs along the layer boundary with a faster propagation velocity V2 of the lower medium. the required angle of incidence is calculated as follows. Sine of 90 degrees divided by V2 is equal to 1 divided by V2 is equal to the sine of the critical angle alpha C divided by V1. It follows that sine alpha C equals V1 divided by V2. On its path along the layer boundary, it constantly radiates seismic energy upwards, again under the critical angle alpha C, so that it can be measured at the Earth's surface. In seismics, a critically refracted wave is referred to as a head wave or mintrop wave. It is particularly useful for determining the location and course of layer boundaries in the Earth's subsurface. The technique of refraction seismics is based on this principle. How can these two fundamental propagation modes of reflection and refraction be used to study the structure of the Earth's interior? In general, seismic propagation velocities in the Earth increase with depth. This is mainly due to the fact that density increases with depth. There are therefore many layer boundaries within the Earth in which head waves can also occur in principle. The head wave propagates in the subsurface with the velocity of the deeper, faster medium. From a certain distance from the source, the head waves impact before the direct waves on the Earth's surface and can therefore be observed particularly well. In contrast to the description of optical beam path at the start of this video, seismic waves cannot be easily visualized. We can, however, simulate their propagation using computers. This is because we know the seismic wave equations as well as the propagation characteristics of seismic waves. If one takes two homogeneous layers, with the lower having a higher propagation velocity of seismic waves, such a wave field results. The black and white areas indicate the wave fronts. Once again, you can see how the wave is propagating from its source. At the layer boundary, it is now reflected and radiated back upwards. At the same time, the wavefront of the head wave forms weakly, depicted here as a straight line. From a certain distance, the head wave impacts on the surface before the direct wave. Due to their higher velocity, they overtake them in the subsurface. In this video, you've learned how reflection and refraction can be explained with the help of Huygens Principle. Both phenomena occur at layer boundaries in the subsurface. In the case of reflection, seismic energy at a layer boundary is radiated back up to the surface. With the refraction of waves, energy penetrates into the lower medium and, depending on the propagation velocity, is refracted towards or away from the perpendicular. The head wave is a specially refracted wave. It propagates along a layer boundary at a velocity of the lower, faster medium. Today, not only individual wave propagation paths, but also entire wave fields can be simulated using high-performance computers. This enables detailed insights to be made into the Earth, for example, to facilitate the discovery of raw materials.